will see 10th grammar, section B, part 2. Under section B, you can attend 5 questions, each carrying 2 marks. So, 10 marks you can get. In the last class, we have seen up to part 13. Today, we are going to see part 14. 25th question, compared with a single sentence. The time is very short. He cannot learn Spanish language. Spanish means it is a language in a way. So it is the time is too short. He cannot learn the language. Here instead of very, you are writing too. And instead of he cannot, you are using too. Here you are using too. For this you are using too. So the answer for this, the time is too short to learn Spanish in a week. So this is the answer for this. If you write it, you can get 2 marks. Now come to the next one. Create is other word. We are going to change it passive form or active form. So, the active voice or passive voice, that's what you want to know. So, for this you must see, if you find the preposition by, you can come to know this, the given sentence is, it is a passive form. But here it is not given by, that is, the verb is gave, only single verb. Since it is single verb, definitely, the given one is in active voice. This is a simple method. For 10th standard, this is a simple method to know whether it is active voice or passive voice. If you find why the given one is passive voice, if you find only single verb, you know this, it is the given one is active voice. So here it is given gave. So definitely the given one, the given sentence is active voice. So you are going to change it to passive form. So when you change passive voice, the single verb will become double verb. Single verb will become double verb. So this is one method. And you are using the preposition by. Here the subject is the manager. Subject, this one verb, the bonus. What the manager gave? The manager gave bonus. So subject, verb, object. This and that I'm known it. To the worker. To whom given? To the worker. And come to the next one. Here again another sentence. After that it is given another sentence. They received it with joy. So here also. You think about it, the given one is a new sentence. So they, subject, received verb in object. They, subject, received verb in object. Which is our next moment. So one verb will be changing into two verb. Subject is changed into object. Object is changed into subject. So now we say the bonus. The bonus, you put a two dash. Since it is one verb, you are going to change into two whole verb. So readily you put two dash and immediately you follow by preposition by. You are using the preposition by. By the manager. So you write the bonus. Here it is given gave. Gave is past tense. Since it is past tense, you can use was and were. This is the rule. The structure is was plus third form verb 3 or were plus verb 3. Were plus verb 3. Verb 3 means past participant. Give, gave, given. You know, give, gave, given. So this is past participle or you can say verb 3. So here we are using verb plus verb 3 where plus verb be. And what is used for singular subject? Where is used for plural subject? This is the formula. This is the formula you come to know while writing the passive voice. So now you to find the singular subject, you see here the bonus. Definitely it is singular subject. So which one you select, first one or second one? You can answer for this. First one or second one?
First
one. So you are selecting was plus verb 3. So here we write was. Verb 3 is given. So the bonus was given to the whom? To the worker by the manager. Here we can write to the worker by the manager. So the first part is over. And next one you can write they. So they is placed in the object and it is placed in the subject. Then it, you put verb in there, do them. Then immediately you write
by.
They will be them. They mean them. So write. And here after ed. Ed means past tense or present tense. Past tense. Ed will be in object past tense formally. So past tense means what you use? Was or were. And when do we use was for singular subject? Where for plural subject. So this is singular or plural? It means singular or plural?
Singular.
So this is singular subject. Yes, yes means singular subject. So you are definitely you are using was. Third form is what? The same. Received. So it was received by them means the. So now we read it fully. The bonus was given to the worker by the manager and it was received by them with dot. The next we are going to see 27th question, direct to indirect speech. The given one is direct speech, we are going to change into indirect speech. Praveen said, I don't go to movies often and my mother will not allow it. So you are writing Praveen. Okay. What is the condition? First of all, you have to see whether it is statement or here is there any question mark or is there any exclamation mark? Nothing at all. Is there any requested? Requested or order or please? That means requested means please. If you don't find such thing, definitely the given one will be a statement, a simple statement. For simple statement, the conjunction, the connecting word will be definitely for that. And here, you are going to say, I, yes. The second person is not given. Only Praveen. The first person here is, the person who is talking is Praveen. So, set will be separately. Not telling as told. When will you tell it as told? Praveen. Set. To Kala. If you find like this, you are saying said to as told. Here, Praveen one person and Kala another person. So, if you find two persons like this, you have to say said to as told. But here, only one person is talking. So, that means said itself. You should not change it as told. So, Praveen said the connecting word is that. Then I refer to Praveen. So boy. Boy means he or she.
He.
He. So Praveen said that he don't. Don't is present. Do. Do means present or boy. Present. So do present. Then you have to change into past. Present should be changed into past. Because here outside past is set. Set anything is there. Past tense. Since it is past tense, everything you are going to change into past tense form. So the don't you are changing into didn't. So Praveen said that he didn't go to. Here go you should not change. Go you should not change it as went. When two verbs Then only the first verb. Second verb you give as it is. So Praveen said that he did it whenever you write it. You should read it. Every time you should read it and check up whether it is correct or wrong. So Praveen said that he didn't go to movies often. And mine refers to Praveen. So we will select his or him. This one we will select. Students may find confused. This one is correct. His or him. His. Him means avanukku. His means avanudaya. So you have to select his. Then this will be suitable person. And his mother. Definitely students will find difficult in selecting whether it is his or him. Here, his mother or him mother. His mother will be changed in the person. Can be good. So good, not allowed. Will he change allowed? Only the first one will be changed as possible, not the second one. So, would not allow him. So, after this it is over. Now, we will read it again. Praveen said that he did not go to movie often and his mother would not allow him. So, here what we have said, will change the word. Then, the connecting word is that. Then, don't mean getting. And then, my name. His, what is it? I means he. So this is the correct answer. If you write this, you can get 2 marks for it. Now come to the if flag. Flag is very very easy one. If it is work well, he would be rewarded. Already we have seen in if flag. For the first part you have to write if. For the first part you have to write if. And one more condition. Here if you find will in the second part, sorry, if you find present tense in the first part, the second part will be will under its class. That means in the first sentence, present tense. And in the second part will be will. If it is past, then the second part will be good. If you find a past verb here, he did his work well, he would be rewarded. So, past is only coming. Would is what? Present tense or past tense? Past tense. Sorry, not good. Did is past tense. Do present tense. Did past tense. Since you find a past tense, here that result is would. Present tense means will. Understood or not? Present tense means will. Past tense means would. So in your past tense, so here also would given. So definitely you have to just write if. Just you write if. You can get 2 marks for this. So if he did his work well, then he would be rewarded. Very easy one. For this you can get 2 marks. Just you are writing in front. Now come to the degrees of comparison. Here they are given the cost of Samsung phone. Which one is costliest of all? 25,000, 18,000, 30,000, 15,000, 40,000. So this is the costliest one. So how you write the degrees of comparison for this? An Apple phone. Here, an Apple phone is you have to use the superlative form, isn't it? So when you use the superlative form, the plus ent, the costliest, iest, you are using INC. The cashier of all. The cashier of all. All we can use, we can take any two. And compare this. This is 25,000. This is 18,000. So you can write a answer. Four is costlier than. You can write IEF. Costlier than. The structure is IEF than. You have to write a answer. Four is. Here you should write is. Is costlier than. Fillet 4. So you can take any two and compare this. You can use costlier than or you can use the superlative of the plus PST, the costliest of all or the costliest one. Thank you.